This really puts you into character of how you feel internally because you are that queen, yes. Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Emmy, if you're new here, welcome. Today I'm going to be bringing you a video about Taylor Swift. We love Taylor Swift. And today I'm going to be telling you what your favorite Taylor Swift album says about you. So I'm gonna go album by album and just tell you if this is your favorite album, this is what it says about you. Let's get started. So we're just gonna start chronologically, which means Taylor Swift is first. So if this is your album, this says that you are good at keeping secrets and trust. Those around you always confide in you, and you're the person they go to when they need somebody to just vent to because they know nothing will get back to anybody else. You're also hardworking and persistent. You go after the things you want, even if people are telling you that you're not gonna make it and things aren't gonna work out. You just keep going in your goals and you're very determined. You also think in a very logical manner, which means you break things down to their smallest pieces, like to things step by step. You often also surprise people with how clever and witty you are. It might sometimes get you into trouble, but it also might surprise some people and get you in the door of places where you might have otherwise lacked experience. You're also very driven by feelings of love and acceptance, which is a good quality to have in some instances when things are good and mutual between the two people, but sometimes you can't trust everybody. You often love the feeling of starting a new adventure, of going somewhere new, starting fresh, because it gives you a feeling of things don't have to be the way they used to be. You can start moving forward without any of your past kind of clouding your judgment now. You can sometimes let comparison get to you and get under your skin and kind of get in your head, which can often come back to bite you in the butt because you often spend time trying to change things about yourself when deep down you know you are who you are. I also think this would be the kind of person that would stay way too long at parties and like not pick up on those social cues. So it's like the person on the floor like petting the dog and they're like asking the host, it's just them, the host, and they're on the floor with petting the dog, and they're asking the host like, oh, is there anything I can do to like clean up? And the host is like, no, it's okay, I got it. And it's like, you just don't get the social cue of this person just trying to clean up and go to bed. But it's not always a negative thing. So the next album is obviously Fearless. So if this is your favorite album, this is what it says about you. You are low-key still stuck on a high school girlfriend / boyfriend, and you're still not kind of over it. You still kind of think about it sometimes, even though you've moved on. Sometimes things and nostalgia bring you back and you still can't help but think of what would have been. You love dressing fancy and in girly dresses because it makes you feel like you're in a fairy tale or a princess movie, and it just really puts you into character of how you feel internally because you are that queen, yes. You would argue with anybody that tells you that love at first sight does not exist, because it indeed does, and they're all just haters. You're also a bit of an optimist, so you like to look at things with like a big wide-eyed and bushy-tailed, and you're all ready, and you're just really excited to be here. Anything could happen, which is gonna benefit you in the long run, because you're gonna take advantage of things that maybe other people wouldn't have. You are a successful person at anything that you set your mind to, and sometimes your success may surprise you, but it really shouldn't, because you know deep down that you work hard for the things that you have, and at the end of the day, you deserve the good things that happen to you. People do tend to think that they can walk all over you because you're very nice and you're too afraid to say anything, but you are working on learning to say no. It's just very hard because you're such a nice person. You can get a bit snarky when faced with drama and in situations where people might not always be the nicest to you or people that you love, but you often regret your instant reactions and your gut reactions, so it's probably best to just, you know, wait it out and then react. You also are a very loyal person. You show up for the people that matter most to you. At the end of the day, these people know you're gonna be there for them, and that's what matters most. You also tend to be a little bit ahead of your time, even if you don't realize it. You also have a desire to get away from the things that you've always known, but there are certain things that are still holding you back, still holding you to the ground, and maybe one day you'll break away, but you're still working on that. Lastly, you tend to share a lot. You wear your heart on your sleeve. Everybody kind of knows what you're thinking and they know where your heart's at, and so this can be a good and a bad thing because, again, it's that vulnerability state, but it's also that kind of pureness that people love so much. So the next album is Speak Now, and if this is your favorite album, this is what it says about you. You always say what you mean. Whether or not it's at the right moment, that's another debate, but you always say what you mean nonetheless, and you're always open and upfront because you fear that if you don't say what you mean, things will just be kind of miserable because you'll be living in this lie. You also can make kind of short-winded decisions on a whim, which can end kind of badly for you. So for example, you might be the type of person that picks a university based off of where your boyfriend's going because you'll think it'll make you happy and you'll think it'll just work out fine and dandy, but then, you know, you get to the university and then you guys break up and then you're just stuck there. So you kind of make decisions on the whim, which can be good and bad, and sometimes it works out and sometimes it doesn't. You're also very, very independent, and you're the kind of person that has the mentality that if you want it done right, you gotta do it yourself. You have this empathetic way to you that kind of just sees the good in people, and so when they're trying to make amends, you want to just accept it, but not necessarily everybody is going to deserve your apology acceptance. Your imagination also tends to run wild. You can come up with scenarios about relationships before you've even had a conversation with this person. This is the type of person that would have a whole Pinterest board dedicated to Harry Styles because you just have that good of like future projection that you know it's gonna work out, and you have a whole storyline. You also tend to be very brave, which goes along with you saying what you feel at the right moment. You're always going to stand up for what is right and call people out on their BS. You also do like having the last word though, so you do find yourself in a little bit of more arguments than you'd like. You also tend to get very determined when somebody doubts your abilities and you have a very strong desire to kind of prove these people wrong. And lastly, while you like the idea of being independent on your own and kind of being separated from some people, you find it hard to not get nostalgic and reminiscent of how things used to be. Sometimes it can just get a little bit overwhelming. So next album is Red, and this is what it means if this is your favorite album. You love fall, anything to do with fall, this is your moment to fall. You love to vibe with a rainy day, a hot like cup of coffee, a pumpkin candle, and a nice like Harry Potter movie in the background so you can just cuddle up and be all warm and cozy. You're also brutally honest, but it can sometimes be to a fault where you kind of share too much honesty. This is kind of what people also love you for, because those that are close to you kind of greatly appreciate this and they kind of go to you when they just need honest feedback. You also know how to say how you feel and what you want at any given moment. Some people might not understand or agree with, but it's going to get you like further in life. You also have a bit of a sad girl mentality. You're the kind of person that finds it cathartic when you're sad to listen to sad songs to feel even sadder. You like to get yourself in that sad hole. You also like to take risks in life in any aspect. Anything safe to you just does not seem worth it. You're bold in how you navigate life, which can sometimes bite you in the butt, but you really wouldn't have it any other way because then you wouldn't get the things you really want. You also have good intuition and prediction of what is right and what is wrong and where you should go with your life. You might not always listen to your gut and you might not always want to listen to your gut, but you always have a good gut feeling when things are going to go wrong. You're also the type of person that likes to believe they don't take things too seriously, but in all reality, when someone says something nasty about you or mean, you kind of do kind of ruminate on that thought and kind of let it get to you. Now you, on the other hand, do know how to forgive the right people, and you do it at the right time because you know that not everyone is going to deserve your forgiveness. You also never truly give up on things. You're very persistent. You need to see things to the end. You like the feeling of completing tasks, kind of checking things off on your to-do list. Next album is 1989. So you're often the life of the party and kind of the energy that holds the whole room together. You often like to invite your friends over to kind of dance around your living room and drink wine and just kind of vibe with everybody. You're also always the friend that people go to when they need a killer outfit. If they're in a pinch, they're calling you up because you got something for everybody. You also spend a lot of time working on your inner monologue in front of the mirror, in the shower, just because you feel like you have a lot of good points and everyone around you says that one day you'd make a really good president. You also went away very far for college or for a job because you thought you would like this new town or city, but then you quickly realized that you're very far from your mom and got homesick very quickly. You also sometimes have like an altered view of reality or just something kind of off from what everybody else is seeing, which can sometimes cause friction between you and the people around you because there's often this like miscommunication between what you're feeling, what you're vibing with, and what everybody else is vibing with. You're also a person that keeps an Instagram aesthetic, and we are all wondering how. You also are a big world traveler. You love going around the world, and if you haven't been to all these countries yet, there are like a long list on your bucket list that you want to go to. You also have a strong sense of accomplishment in your life. You like striving for specific goals. You like hitting landmarks. You are just looking after your world domination and you see no end in sight. And while you also like to share your experiences with other people because it makes you feel more connected, you also like to put up boundaries and walls so that people can't know too much. Next album is Reputation, and these are the things it means if this is your favorite album. Snake Hoodie. I actually thrifted this from Plato's Closet for $9. I know. Anyways, this is what it means if Reputation is your favorite album. You're a bit of a nonconformist. You like to do things that other people may think you're weird for doing, but you kind of stick to your guns, you like what you like, and you do what you do because you know that that's what's gonna make you happy at the end of the day. Also, you somehow find yourself in a bit of drama sometimes, and you really don't know why, but it just attracts you. You tend to have a tough exterior about you, but this is just a front because it kind of scares you to be open and vulnerable with so many people, so you kind of put up this front. You also like to just cut right to the chase. There is absolutely no messing around. You don't like to waste any time. You just think that say what you need to say or be done with it. Also, when the wine is flowing, the choreography comes out. It just says, hello, hi. You're also the kind of person that believes you don't necessarily deserve true love or all the good things that happen to you in life, but this just couldn't be farther from the truth. You're also the kind of person that likes to throw a party where everyone feels welcome. Not like a banger, but it's more like you throw the party, but it's like, you know, seven people, and it's like everybody actually likes each other. You often can try to hide your emotions to the point where it affects your relationships, and this can sometimes bite you in the butt because sometimes people might not understand where you're coming from. You also tend to have a genuine happiness inside of you, and it's only the people that kind of know you well that can see this. Next album is Lover, obviously, and this is what it means if this is your favorite album. So you're usually driven by your emotions, which it can sometimes get the best of you, but in your mind, this is the best way you get your point across and you get the things you want. You're also kind of vulnerable, but in the best way. Sometimes it's something you can be ashamed of, but it's usually something that people really admire you for and kind of thank you for, because you bring that realness and rawness to the table that we've all been wanting. If it's not summer, you simply do not want it. You're also that friend that seems to have a relationship where they're genuinely happy in and they're really vibing with their partner, and people really aspire to kind of have this same happiness and elation in their own relationship. And if you're the kind of person that isn't in a relationship, you kind of aspire to have a relationship that is so raw, pure, and happy. You're also confident in the things that you want, and you're done letting people tell you what you should want, because you know deep down that these are the things you want, and so you're just not gonna let all these subliminal messages tell you otherwise. You're also that kind of person that may or may not cry in the back of the car or the Uber because, you know, alcohol and social situations just get you fired up, get you revved up, and anything could really set you off. It really doesn't matter. You also like to celebrate your wins as they come. You like to just take it one day at a time because you're not really sure when the next triumph or big thing is going to happen for you. Food is your lover as well as your lover. This is a very high motivation for you. You also sometimes have these invasive thoughts about situations happening or your relationship kind of going awry due to things that are out of your control. You usually are able to snap out of these kind of fantasies or situations in your mind, but there's kind of these underlying insecurities that never truly go away. You're also a very fun-loving person who knows how to have a good time, and you know when to let things go, when things are worth kind of focusing on and worrying about, and when they're just not. And lastly, we have folklore. You tend to be quite humble. You don't like to come off as braggy or whatnot, but you do know your worth, and you're not really willing to settle for anything less. You're also like the quiet friend who doesn't say stuff all the time, doesn't always have things to add, but when you do, they damn well know it's gonna be scandalous and they better clean out their ears and listen up. You also find social situations to be a little bit draining, and so you were kind of relieved when quarantine happened that you had time to kind of work on yourself. You also deleted social media for 2 weeks and now you are spiritually awakened. You're also like a bad bitch, but like in a low-key way. Like, you don't take shit, but the second it requires like a little bit amount of effort, you just like dip. You also are extremely sentimental and you enjoy all of the small things that people do for you or have done for you in the past. And it's just kind of one of those things that just comforts you when you're kind of feeling lonely. You're also unapologetically yourself, and you'd be damned if anybody made you apologize for it. And you're simply just like unbothered at this point. You also like to think about the decisions you've made in life and how they've kind of defined the direction that you have went in your life, and you like to fantasize about what could have been if this didn't happen, or if you had made a different decision where you might have ended up in life. Time also fascinates you. It's kind of this thing that stop feeling real after a little while. You're also not one to get like petty about things, but you will defend those you love and you will go for blood if they threaten you or those you love. You still have insecurities, mainly from your past, that still are finding a way to kind of affect your present and who you are now. You know more clearly what you want and who you want to be, but you can't kind of change those past experiences you had. And while you can vocalize them all you want, you really truly never see them going away. So yes, that is all of the albums and what they mean about you if those are your favorites. If you liked the video, please give it a like. And if you want to see more from me, please subscribe down below, and I'll see you next time. Peace!